This is the all-new second-generation Isuzu Mu-X 7-seater SUV, which looks almost completely identical to the upcoming 2022 D-Max at first glance. Well, that's because this SUV is based on the D-Max. Think of it as a D-Max with extra seats at the back instead of the loading bin. The upcoming D-Max is built right here in South Africa in Port Elizabeth, and it will be hitting showrooms around May-June this year. You would be forgiven for thinking that this car kind of looks like the Chevrolet Trailblazer, cause it somewhat does. In fact, the Trailblazer was based on the Mu-X platform, and that was as a result of a partnership between General Motors and Isuzu. General Motors was manufacturing Chevrolet and Opel cars here in SA, and they left the country at the end of 2017. The General Motors production plant in Port Elizabeth was acquired by Isuzu, which is where they are currently manufacturing the D-Max. Isuzu also had an agreement with General Motors to continue servicing Chevrolet cars for 10 years, starting from 2018. So if you still own a Chevrolet car here in SA after 2027, you'll be on your own, unless there's a new agreement in place. So if you're planning to buy a Chevrolet Cruze or Spark at We Buy Cars this year, good luck. May the odds be in your favor. Enough about history lessons. Let's actually take a look at the car right in front of us. Welcome to another video. This car has quite an aggressive front end. The grille is in your face, and it gives the car some presence. From this angle, you'd swear this is the D-Max, and we can somewhat consider this review a 2-in-1 review, cause by the end of this video, you will already know what the upcoming D-Max has to offer. The Mu-X comes with LED headlamps and daytime running lights as standard. There's a single fog lamp at the bottom, which is one way of differentiating this car from its bulky sibling, cause the D-Max has dual lamps in the fog lamp region. Moving on to the side profile, this car comes with 17-inch wheels as standard, and the wheels you are seeing here definitely didn't come with the car. There's an integrated side step and some roof rails on top. I'm not sure if they are functional or not, cause to me they just look too cute to be functional. Overall, the side profile just looks like any other 7-seater SUV. There's nothing special and nothing to complain about. At the back, this Mu-X is new, but all I can see is the old Chevrolet Trailblazer, and that's not a bad thing. What I like the most here is that there's no fake exhaust cutouts, cause I hate it when car manufacturers do that. The boot capacity is 311 liters when all the seats are up, which is expandable to 1119 liters when the third row seats are folded. There's some lights and a 12 volt socket here at the back as well. This is a 7-seater, and inside it has 3 rows of seats. There's 2 seats in the 3rd row, 3 in the 2nd row, and 2 in front. The cloth seats are comfortable, but they just feel like they are made out of pick and pay grocery bags. I don't understand why a car that starts from 771,000 rands doesn't come with proper leather seats. And I hate the visible white stitching on the seats. It just looks horrible. In front, there's a multi-function steering wheel and a touch MM system. This interior design is the same as the one of the D-Max, with just minor differences here and there. Overall, the design is okay. It's not my style, but some people will love it. This car has an electronic handbrake with auto hold, and since it is a 4x4, it has that 4x4 selection chandies and the rear diff lock activation button. At the back, legroom is a bit compromised, but there's no issues with headroom. There's air vents and 2 USB ports so that your passengers can charge their iPhone 6, which must be always on life support. The Mu-X is available in 4 variants, which are the LS, LSE, LS4x4 and Onyx4x4. They all have the same 3.0 turbocharged diesel engine coupled with a 6-speed automatic transmission. The engine has a power output of 140 kilowatts and 450 Nm of torque. This SUV has an impressive claimed average fuel consumption of only 7.6 liters per 100 kilometers. In terms of pricing, the base model Mu-X LS starts from 693,000 rands and the top of the range Onyx starts from 860,000 rands. With this car, you get a 5-year 120,000 kilometers warranty, which is great compared to the pathetic 3-year warranty you get with VW and Toyota cars. You also get a 5-year 90,000 kilometers service plan. So would I recommend that you buy this car? For now, yes. But I can't wait to see how will the upcoming Chery Tiggo 8 Pro stack up against this car. Personally, if I was on the market for a 7-seater SUV, I would also consider the Toyota Fortuner because it has a much lower entry price than the Mu-X, and you get leather seats with all the Fortuner models. Share your thoughts on this 7-seater in the comment section. My goal is to reach 25,000 subscribers on the channel by the end of 2022, so if you haven't subscribed, please help by smashing the subscribe button. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel for more car content in a Mzansi context.